Israel confirms the deaths of 31 of the over 100 hostages still held in Gaza. No details on their identities and how they were killed were disclosed. The news comes amid efforts to secure the release of remaining captives in exchange for a long pause in the fighting. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken is in the Middle East this week to advance the Egyptian-Qatari mediated deal with Hamas militants.
The best path forward, the most effective path forward right now to get an extended period of calm and to work toward an end to the conflict is through an agreement on the hostages. And that's what we're intensely focused on with our partners here in Qatar, Egypt, working with Israel. And of course, now that we have the response from Hamas to the proposal that was put on the table a week or so ago, we're going to be very intensely focused on that.
U.S. President Joe Biden also affirms the deal is moving forward.
There is some movement, and I don't want to choose my words. There's some movement. There's been a response from the opposition. From Hamas. But it seems to be a little over the top. We're not sure where it is. There's a continuing negotiation right now.
Israel now looking into whether its soldiers were also guilty of killing hostages and civilians during the October 7 attack by Hamas. The investigation will reportedly focus on a community in Be'eri where at least a dozen hostages were killed after an Israeli shelling. The October 7 attack triggered the start of the now four-month-long war, which has killed 1,200 in Israel. Meanwhile, Israel's air and ground invasion of Gaza have left over 27,000 Palestinians dead. Chile's former president Sebastián Piñera dies in a helicopter crash. He was 74. The helicopter carrying Piñera and three others plunged into a lake in southern Chile. He was pronounced dead shortly after rescuers arrived at the scene. The other three passengers survived. The Chilean government has declared a period of national mourning for the former president. Piñera oversaw Chile's quick economic growth and a steep fall in unemployment during his first term as president from 2010 to 2014. His second term, though, from 2018 to 2022, was marked by violent protests against inequality. Now, no sweeping immunity for former U.S. President Donald Trump. A federal appeals court ruled Trump can be prosecuted for alleged crimes he committed during his presidency, including efforts to overturn his 2020 election defeat. The three-judge panel unanimously said, despite the privileges Trump once held, he was subject to federal criminal law like any other American. This brings Trump a step closer to an unprecedented criminal trial. Trump's lawyers previously argued former presidents are entitled to sweeping legal protections and could not be criminally prosecuted unless removed from office. During his presidency, Trump was impeached twice by the U.S. House, but Senate Republicans cast enough votes to acquit him. Trump's latest legal setback comes as Nevada voters head to the polls with his name not on the ballot. Trump's last remaining rival, Nikki Haley, is set to win the state's primary. But even with her victory, Trump is poised to secure all of the state's delegates in a separate caucus Thursday. See, a 2021 state law scrapped Nevada's presidential caucuses in favor of primaries. But the Nevada Republican Party still opted to hold caucuses this year. It's not as confusing for Democrats, with U.S. President Joe Biden expected to easily win the primary after dominating his party's first nominating contest in South Carolina.
It does matter. I don't want Trump in there at all. He's not worth it.
Why?
Liar. Cheater, liar. People fall around like sheep.
Well, I actually voted for none of the above here.
because the primary here didn't include all of the people, and I'll be going in Thursday for the caucus to vote for Trump. Well, I believe his last 4 years, we had prosperity and peace, and I'm looking for the same thing without all the nonsense that's been going on.
Britain's King Charles seen in public Tuesday, the first time since his cancer diagnosis was made public. Charles smiled and waved to passersby as he was driven the short distance from his Clarence House home in central London to the Buckingham Palace. Meanwhile, Prince Harry flew to London after news broke about his father's condition. The British public hopes Prince Harry's return will lead to a reconciliation in the royal family.
Sounds nice. I mean, like, this whole family feud thing seems a bit silly in my opinion. They should make up, and hopefully this brings them together a little bit more.
I mean, you know, he's got to come back to see his father, hasn't he? I mean, it's the right thing to do.
Now let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are news making headlines for Filipinos in North America. We begin with a powerful storm system soaking parts of California, leaving at least three people dead from falling trees. For days now, California has been hit by one of the most catastrophic storms in state history. And it's not over yet. The National Weather Service says this second atmospheric river to hit California in a week would dump close to half a year's worth of rain by Tuesday. Governor Gavin Newsom has already declared a state of emergency in eight counties. As of Tuesday morning, more than 150,000 households have lost power as unprecedented levels of rainfall caused dangerous flooding and hundreds of mudslides.
People forget how to drive, and it's actually become a lot dangerous. There are a lot of like palm tree, like debris or parts on the floor. There's just a lot of mess everywhere.
It was just like really like windy and rainy, and then all of a sudden it just cut out. So our power outage has almost lasted for 24 hours already. And as a college student, it's kind of been hard as like we kind of rely on power to like get our stuff done.
The threat of flash flooding continues for much of Southern California, with more rainfall expected on Tuesday.
Meanwhile, as the first Manila International Film Festival caps off with an awarding ceremony, all eyes were on Filipino veteran actress Hilda Coronel.
Hilda Coronel was honored with the Manila International Film Festival's Monte Manibong Lifetime Achievement Award. The award is named after community pioneer Monte Manibong, one of the first Filipino-American attorneys to practice law in the United States. And in the 1970s, he eventually became a city council member and mayor of Monterey Park, just outside of Los Angeles. Coronel, who started her career in the 1970s, accepted the award in front of some 600 people at the Directors Guild of America, including fellow Philippine celebrities like Piolo Pascual, Tirso Cruz III, Christopher De Leon, and Ding Dong Dantes.
It's fascinating, and I'm really happy for all the Filipinos that make it everywhere in the world, but especially here now that they're here. It's really thrilling.
In recent years, Coronel has been staying in the U.S. away from the spotlight with her late husband, Ralph Moore Jr.
I'd like to dedicate this to my husband, Ralph Moore Jr., who last year has earned his wings.
And finally, a new Hollywood star is born. Liza Zuberano dazzles at the Lisa Frankenstein premiere.
Glowing from Hollywood's warm reception and rave reviews of her breakout performance in Lisa Frankenstein, Liza Zuberano attended the film's Hollywood premiere.
I play a supporting character, obviously, in Lisa Frankenstein, and it's just so overwhelming to hear that people really love my character and they really love like the comedic timing that I bring to the story and everything. So I'm very touched because I really enjoyed the process of making the film, and I'm really just grateful that everybody appreciates that.
It was a tornado watch, Mom, not a real tornado.
Soberano also shares that she is constantly auditioning in Hollywood and already has a project lined up in development. Despite the stormy weather in Los Angeles, the film's team came in full force to the premiere, including lead stars Catherine Newton and Cole Sprouse, director Zelda Williams, and writer Diablo Cody.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.